Joe here with the Rideshare Guy, and today we're going to discuss Lime and how to become a juicer. So Lime is another shared scooter company. They launched in January of 2017, and in just 2 years, they've grown to a valuation of over $1 billion. Lime offers those shared scooters, and also they offer smart and electric assist bikes. Their scooters and bikes are available in hundreds of US cities and college campuses, as well as worldwide in much of Europe and Australia. And in order to charge their shared scooters, they need people to go out and collect them and bring them home to charge. They call their chargers juicers. Juicing, as Lime calls it, is another gig job, much like rideshare driving and food delivery. You make $5 minimum per scooter you charge, and up to $20 for the difficult to find ones. Juicers go out and collect scooters that need to be charged, bring them home to charge them, once they're fully charged, they bring them out and release them back out for the public to use. In addition to doing rideshare, I've done some juicing myself. I've gone out and collected scooters at night, brought them home and charged them overnight, and then the next day before I log in to drive, I'll bring them out and release them for people to use. So how do you become a juicer? You can sign up via their website. Once you have entered all the necessary information, you'll need to complete a how to juice course. After that, you'll need to sign what they call an independent juicer agreement. And once you've signed that, all you have to do is wait and receive an email letting you know when your chargers are ready. Once you receive that email, then you can order your chargers and you'll go to their online store and purchase your chargers. Chargers are currently listed at $19 a piece, but you may be able to get a discount. When I ordered mine, I was given a discount code for 4 free chargers. All I had to pay was $6 in shipping. And once you receive your charges, you're all set to begin juicing. For me personally, it took about 2 weeks from when I signed up to be a juicer to receive my chargers in the mail. So there are a few steps to becoming a juicer, but for the most part, it's pretty straightforward. And it's pretty easy work. It's a pretty great way to earn some extra income. I've done it a couple of times where I've gone out at night, say 9 o'clock at night, I'll go out, I'll collect 4 scooters, and that took me probably about half an hour to collect the scooters and bring them home, charge them, set them up to do that, and then release them the next day. I'd say all in all, it took about an hour. All of the labor was about an hour going out, getting them, bringing them home, doing all of that. So I'd say, and I got $5 for each scooter, so that's $20. Now, and that's just initially when I first tried it. Once you become more proficient at it, you can go out and collect a lot more scooters and probably make a lot more per hour. And I was just collecting the minimum ones, the more hard to find ones. Granted, it may take you a little bit more time to find those, but you can get paid better for those scooters. And it can be fun. It's basically like a scavenger hunt. You're going out, you're collecting these scooters. It's something different. It's different than rideshare driving. If you are a rideshare driver, it's a great way to piggyback on the work you're already doing. Say you're out, you end your day, your night near a downtown area. You could just collect the scooters, bring them home, charge them like I've done, and then release them back out before you log in the next day. If you've thought about becoming a juicer, I would really recommend giving it a try. If you haven't subscribed to the Rideshare Guy channel, please subscribe. We post new videos every single week. Thanks again for watching and drive safe. Thanks.